Hello everyone, thank you for joining us in our pre-recorded Drone Safety Day webinar series. Drone Safety Day is aimed at promoting safe drone practices and exploring the cool and innovative ways drones are being used across Canada. My name is Shaheen Chohan, and I'm a policy analyst that works on the Remotely Piloted Aircraft Systems, or Drone Task Force, at Transport Canada. Transport Canada is the department of the federal government responsible for regulating and developing transportation policies and programs, including those relating to drones. I'm joined by Anne-Sophie Riopelle-Bouvier with Unmanned Systems Canada, or USC, Canada's largest drone association.
Good day, and thank you, Shaheen, for the introduction. My name is Anne-Sophie, and I'm a director and flight safety officer with Unmanned Systems Canada. We are the national industry association representing the growing community of businesses, organizations, educators, and enthusiasts in the drone, remotely piloted, unmanned, and robotic vehicle system sector. I am also the co-founder and vice president of operations for Quebec-based Exotactic Air Support. I was nominated to the board of directors of Unmanned Systems Canada in 2018 and helped to launch our national flight safety action team. I combine my experiences as a Canadian Forces flight safety officer, co-founder and VP of operations with Exotactic Air Support, and my background in urban intelligence to support my work at USC.
In this webinar, Anne-Sophie and I will outline the steps to becoming a drone pilot, the rules you must adhere to while flying, and general drone safety tips. Remember, drone safety is everyone's responsibility, and you should always know before you go. We'll start with the rules and requirements for drones weighing between 250 grams and 25 kilograms. Smaller drones are often called micro drones, and we'll talk about those later.
There are two categories your drone operation will fall into, basic and advanced. Each drone has a different set of rules drone pilot must follow. The rules for basic operations try to minimize the risk a drone pilot poses to other aircraft and to people. Pilots are required to fly only in uncontrolled airspace. They must keep their drone at least 30 meters from bystanders and never fly over bystanders at any height. If conducting advanced operation, you can fly in controlled airspace, fly closer than 30 meters to bystanders and fly over them. However, you'll need a drone with the required flight safety assurance rating based on how you want to use your drone. We will go into more details about safety assurance ratings later on.
This infographic, taken from Transport Canada's drone safety website, shows the difference between basic and advanced operations. Basic operations are defined by flying in uncontrolled airspace, more than 30 meters from bystanders, and never flying over bystanders. If you do not meet any one of these three conditions, you are conducting advanced operations. For example, let's say you fly your drone more than 30 meters from bystanders, but in controlled airspace. This operation is advanced because you're flying in controlled airspace, even if you're more than 30 meters from bystanders.
Flying over bystanders is an advanced operation, but you and your crew, if you have one, are not bystanders. Controlled airspace is where air traffic control, ATC, is provided and is usually near airports and heliports. Uncontrolled airspace is where ATC is not provided and is called Class G airspace.
Airspace is divided into classes A through G. All classes except G are controlled airspace, and to fly in them, you'll need an advanced pilot certificate and permission from NAV Canada, the agency that controls Canada's airspace. We'll provide more information on getting this permission later in the webinar. You can fly your drone in Class G uncontrolled airspace with a basic pilot certificate. Our interactive map, called the Drone Site Selection Tool, lets you find a safe space to fly your drone, as well as identify what class of airspace you'll be flying in. This image on the slide was taken from the Drone Site Selection Tool. We've included the link to the Drone Site Selection Tool, as well as all the other links we will mention in this webinar, on the final slide. All this to say, airspace is really complicated. Navigating the classes of controlled airspace requires coordination with NAV Canada and additional training, which is why we distinguish between basic and advanced operations.
To conduct basic operations with a drone that weighs between 250 grams and 25 kilograms, you first need to register your drone and mark it. You can register your drone online at canada.ca/drone-safety through the drone management portal. It costs $5 to register your drone and takes less than 3 minutes. You will need the following information: the date you purchased your drone and the make, model, serial number, weight, and type of drone you have. If you build your drone at home, you can leave these fields empty. Once you register your drone, you will receive a certificate of registration, which you can either print or save digitally. You must mark your drone with your registration number before you fly. You can use a permanent marker, a permanent label, or you can engrave it. Registering your drone is the law, but it's also important in other ways. If you lose your drone, registration can help it get it returned to you when it's found. And if there's a recall from the manufacturer, Transport Canada may be able to notify you.
The next step is to pass the basic exam. You can take the exam online through the Drone Management Portal at canada.ca/drone-safety. It costs $10 and you'll have 90 minutes to complete it. It has 35 multiple choice questions. A score of 65% or higher is considered a pass, and you'll get your results as soon as you complete the exam.
You've registered your drone and obtained a drone pilot certificate. Now you're ready to fly while adhering to flight safety rules. To keep yourself and others safe, fly your drone where you can see it, below 400 feet, and away from controlled airspace, airports, bystanders, emergency operation, advertised events such as concerts or parades, and other aircraft. Have your registration and pilot certificates on hand, either as print or digital versions when you're flying. Transport Canada can fine you if you do not mark your drone with its registration number or have your registration and pilot certificates on hand when flying. The fines are up to $1,000 for a person and $5,000 for a corporation.
Advanced operations have more requirements than basic operations. The first step is to choose the right drone. Advanced operations pose more of a risk to people and aircraft than basic operations, so you need a drone that meets the RPAS safety assurance requirements. You can find out which drones are eligible for advanced operations on our Drone Safety website, meaning that RPAS safety assurance for one advanced operation does not make the drone fit for all of them. For example, a drone may be allowed to operate at a horizontal distance less than 30 meters from bystanders, but not over them.
The next task is to register your drone. The same process applies as with basic operations.
Next, you need to pass the advanced exam. As with the basic exam, you can take the advanced exam online through the Drone Management Portal at canada.ca/drone-safety. The advanced exam also costs $10, but instead of 90 minutes to complete the exam, you have 60. The exam has 50 multiple choice questions, and a score of 80% or higher is considered a pass. As soon as you complete the exam, you'll get your results and reference number. You'll need this number to complete the next step in this process, passing a flight review. If you fail a basic or advanced exam, you must pay the $10 fee every time you attempt it again. You can retake an exam as many times as you wish, but you must wait 24 hours between attempts.
Flight reviewers are Transport Canada approved drone pilots who can administer a flight review. Every flight reviewer is associated with a self-declared drone flight school. Contact the drone flight school directly to schedule a flight review. You must provide the school with your registration certificate and prove that you passed the advanced exam. The flight reviewer will assess your ability to operate your drone safely. You may be charged a fee for your flight review. Prices are set by reviewers and can vary. Within 24 hours of your flight review, the flight reviewer will submit your results online and you will receive an email confirmation with a link to view your results. If you pass, you can apply for an advanced operations pilot certificate. If you fail, you can schedule another review as early as the next day. There is no limit to the number of times you can retake a flight review, but you may need to pay a fee each time. You can apply for the Advanced Operation Pilot Certificate online. You will be charged a fee of $25. You will then be provided an electronic copy of your Advanced Pilot Certificate.
You've registered a drone that has the necessary RPAS safety assurance, and you've obtained your Advanced Operations Pilot Certificate. Now you're ready to fly. Fly your drone where you can see it, below 400 feet, and away from airports, emergency operations, advertised events such as concerts or parades, and other aircraft. If you'll be flying in controlled airspace, you'll need permission from Air Traffic Control, or ATC.
As we discussed earlier, controlled airspace is managed by ATC. Usually that means NAV Canada, but it may be different near a military base. To fly in controlled airspace, which is Class C, D, or E airspace, you need authorization. If ATC for your given airspace is NAV Canada, you must submit an RPAS flight authorization request.
This slide lists the most important resources to study for your exam. We strongly recommend that you attend a drone flight school before attempting the advanced exam. The training you'll get from a drone flight school is specific to how you'll use your drone. The last slide in this webinar has a link to an online listing of flight schools. It also lists other study material for both the basic and advanced exams.
After you have received either your basic or advanced pilot certificate, you need to keep your skills up to date to remain certified. Every 2 years, you'll need to rewrite the exam, pass a flight review for an advanced certificate, or participate in a safety seminar, drone training program, or self-study program. Remember, if you let your skills lapse for more than 2 years, you may lose your certification. just like your registration certificate or pilot certificate, you must keep proof on you that you've retained your knowledge whenever you fly.
Based on your flight and the operation you'll be conducting, you might have to respect other rules and laws. For example, drone operations are not permitted in national parks and some provincial and municipal parks. We encourage you to read relevant sections of the Criminal Code and your province's laws on trespassing and privacy before you fly for the first time. Some municipalities also have bylaws restricting drone use.
So that covers most of the rules and requirements flying a drone. Next, we'll go over procedures you should follow before taking off. First, find a safe place to fly your drone. Drones share airspace with other drones and aircraft, so use Transport Canada's drone site selection tool to ensure you're flying where it is permitted. Second, consult a notice to airmen, NOTAMs, for your flight location. NOTAMs tell pilots about events and obstacles that may affect them. Enter the ID of an aerodrome near you into NAV Canada's portal to find NOTAMs in your area. Third, take note of potentially hazardous obstacles such as buildings and power lines before you fly. Finally, if you will be flying over private property or near or over buildings, we recommend you get consent from the building owner or occupants.
We've gone over the rules and requirements you need to follow when flying your drone. But what happens when the operation you want to conduct falls outside the normal rules? That's when you need to obtain a Special Flight Operation Certificate, or SFOC. You'll need to get an SFOC if your drone is heavier than 25 kilograms, if you want to fly your drone where you can't see it, if you're not a Canadian citizen or permanent resident, if you want to fly higher than 400 feet, or if you want to fly at an advertised event or a special event. You'll also need an SFOC if you want to fly your drone carrying dangerous or hazardous payloads, or if you want to fly close to a military airport. You can complete an application for an SFOC online and submit it to our Regional Center of Expertise. Apply as soon as possible before you plan to use your drone. If information is missing, your application may take longer to process. Transport Canada is not currently accepting SFOC applications from foreigners to Canada who want to fly recreationally. This is a temporary restriction and will be reevaluated in 2021.
Most of what we've covered applies to drones weighing between 250 grams and 25 kilograms. But what about drones that weigh less than 250 grams, also known as micro drones? Unlike drones that weigh more than 250 grams, micro drones do not need to be registered, and you don't need a drone pilot certificate to operate. Keep in mind, though, that the maximum takeoff weight for micro drones must be less than 250 grams, including the weight of accessories such as lights, cameras, or sensors. So if your drone weighs 249 grams, but you had lights that weigh 10 grams, your drone is no longer considered a micro drone. If this happens, you must follow the rules for drones weighing between 250 grams and 25 kilograms, including registering your drone and getting a drone pilot certificate. A micro drone is not a toy, and you must never put people or aircraft in danger. This means staying away from emergency sites and restricted airspace. You can use the drone site selection tool to find out what airspace you can fly in and follow all relevant laws, including those about privacy and trespassing. And you should fly your drone below 400 feet where you can see it and away from advertised events and airports. Regardless of the size of your drone, whether it weighs more than 250 grams or less, you must always fly safely and take care to avoid endangering people around you or other aircraft.
In this last section, we'll take a look at drone rules for kids, flying at night and indoors, and what it means to be fit to fly. Drones are a new and exciting technology and can be a great way for kids to learn, as long as they're keeping it safe by following the rules. Children need to be 14 years old to get a basic license and 16 years old to get an advanced license. Children younger than 14 or 16 can still operate a drone, but only when they're supervised by someone with a license. This means that as a parent, you must possess either a basic or advanced pilot certificate yourself. This requirement does not apply to micro drones. However, we recommend educating your children on safe drone practices and supervising them when they're using their drone.
Part 9 of the Canadian Aviation Regulations only applies to outdoor drone operations and does not apply if flying a drone indoors or underground. When you fly indoors, though, you should get permission from the building owner or occupants and respect all other laws and rules to ensure you don't put anyone in danger. You can fly your drone at night if your drone has position lights. A final note. To operate your drone safely, you must be fit to fly. That means not flying if you're extremely tired, under the influence of alcohol or taking an impairing drug. Make sure you have not had a drink for at least 12 hours before operating your drone, or consume cannabis in the previous 28 days. If your physical and mental capacities are impaired, you can't react quickly to avoid accidents or collisions.
So that's it for safe drone practices, tips, rules, and requirements. We hope you found this webinar helpful. Fly safe and have fun. The next webinars in our Drone Safety Day pre-recorded webinar series will explore the cool and innovative ways drones are being used across Canada. Be sure to check them out as well. Got questions about safe drone operations or something you may have seen or heard during our webinars? Tune in to Transport Canada's Twitter chat to be held on November 13th at 1 p.m. We'll have a group of drone experts available on hand to answer any burning questions you may have live. Drone safety is everyone's responsibility. To celebrate Drone Safety Day, tell us what drone safety means to you. Share a photo, post, or story to your social media platforms with the hashtag Drone Safety Day. And check out Transport Canada's Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram to see what drone safety means to other Canadians.